A very good morning to all my dear children. Once again, your English ma'am welcome you all in your English class. Today, I am going to teach you a fresh writing section, and that is biographical sketch. Cleared? So what is this biographical sketch, children? May in your grammar book, you won't find this topic. So have full attention in the class, focus on, okay, then only you would be able to understand it. Whether this topic is very easy, there is nothing. Biography you must have heard so many times. What is biography? Biography is simply an essay written on a person's life. Means this biography has an account of a person's whole life journey. We count the person's full name, his date of birth, date of place. Then we talk about his academics, his family background. A part of that, we discuss about his career, his likes and dislikes. And we give a brief introduction about his achievements, means whatever he has achieved in his life, the titles or the awards or the honor given by the society to him. So these all things are included in a biography. So the same thing we are going to learn today. Basically, biography have the details, the overall view of a person's life journey. Clear? So when the biography is written by someone else about some about the third person, so that is biography. But when you write your own life story by your own, so that is autobiography. Clear? Means when you yourself is writing about your life, your whole life journey, so that is autobiography. But when someone else describe, give the details of your life and your activities, so that is biography. So same thing, children, we are going to learn today. That is titled as biographical sketch. So what is a biography, children? You must have understood that biography or biographical sketch usually provides an account of a person's life and includes core information. Core information means the important information. We discuss only, we give the detail of those things only that you think is important to know for the listener. We don't talk about the silly little incidents taking place in life. We only discuss those matters that really have an impact on our subject. Then it is used to describe an individual's qualifications, as I told you, the academic we discuss on. Then experiences, children, includes the career of that person and highlight the person's achievements. It is a one or two paragraph description of one's personal and professional identity. Means we don't write too much. We give a brief, concise description about the person's life. Cleared? Now, it can be written on someone else's life, that is known as biography, or your own life, that is known as autobiography. It generally ranges from 50 to 300 words. Means if I count it on a page, so children, biography should not be more than one page. One page in sense, one side, and the other side, I count only half of the page. Okay, so don't write more than that in a biography. Now, what are the elements of a good biographical sketch? Elements means what feature it must have. So, in a biographical sketch, we describe and discuss the life of a real person. Real person means whomsoever you have chosen to write on. Okay, that person must be an a original personality. It should not be a fictional personality, any imaginary personality. We can't write the biographical sketch on that genie or Aladdin, or whether you can say the Pinocchio or the Rapunzel. No. We always choose a real person, a real personality to write on biography, okay? And provide the information based on facts. Instead of coining a story that has no base, we must try to provide the core information, means the information that can be relayed or may be available on other sources. Okay, means if a person wants to check them, so can be easily checked by the other sources. Now, incidents and dialogues and people must be accurate and form a reliable source accounts. Whatever details you are providing about your subject, means the person you are going to write on, okay, the incidents or the dialogues or the people that you have given the description related to your subject, that must be accurate. Accurate means correct. There must have some authenticity. It should not be that I am talking about Sachin Tendulkar and giving a little description about his achievement in Bollywood or Hollywood, or we have given a reference of his cooking also, or maybe miss going beyond his field if we give a little description. So that is not authentical. The listener can guess very easily that whatever details or the accounts you have given, they are not reliable. After that, the person's life story is told with respect. With respect means as far as possible. Try to avoid to give the description of the bad part, the poor part of the person's life. Poor part is whatever bad things he has done, or whatever things that has defamed that person, or can make him embarrassed. Okay, we should not discuss those things. Means we must try to avoid discussing those things that can degrade that person, that can spoil the image of that person. Always give the detail of those things that create a positive image of that person. Okay, so that is why the person's life story is told with respect to other people and events of the time in which they lived. Means the sequencing of the thing should be very, very proper. Next point is, develops an understanding of places, time, events and other people when the person lived. Develop an understanding of places means give the description in such a manner that the listener would be able to trust on you. Means whatever accounts you have given in your writing, in your biography, that must sound authentic, that must sound accurate. Okay, so your language, your sequencing of giving the facts and description must be as such that it would give an idea that yes, you are talking about a real person and whatever information you are providing, that is also true. Tell the story in a style and tone that the reader or the listener can relate to the person and believe in their humanness. Humanness means your writing, your biography must have an impact of reality. Means it must sound that it is real. You are talking about a real person, real personality. Okay, means normally we choose whether a celebrity or a politician or a spokesperson to write on, or whether we can write biography on such a person also that have a good image in the society. May doesn't have any international image or may not be known by many people. But suppose, like, if I talk about my father or grandfather or any of my relative, so they have a good image in my eye. And if I write a biography on them, so the description should be as such, children, that whatever we are talking about, many of the people don't know about them because their details are not available on the media or in the books. So how the people will come to know about your father? Suppose you are writing the biography on your father. So how the people will come to know about your father? By your reading only, by your biography only. So describe those features, those qualities only that sounds authentic. Means after reading that, the person, the listener or the reader must get an idea that what is the exact picture of your father, what kind of person he is, what is his character. Okay, now develop a person as a real, as I told you, an interesting person, not a stereotype person. Stereotype is very common, very boring, very much conservative, the person who doesn't interact with others. If we give such kind of reference in our biography, so that will not develop the liking of the reader. Okay, so develop a person as a real and interesting person means your biography must have some such adjectives, some must have the description of such good qualities, some unique features of that person that the reader must be delighted, must get an idea that yes, whosoever about he is reading is an interesting person. The next point to discuss is tips on writing a biographical sketch. Means aap usko likhte time what you have to keep remember. Okay, now remember your purpose. What is the purpose behind writing the biography? We are giving an account of a person, of a real person. So how many things you are going to include in that? You will focus on the following basic information. What you have to write on? You have to first write on the full name, then date of birth or place of birth. Then you talk about the family background. In family background, you will discuss about the parents, but that should be in brief. Then occupation. What was he doing? What was he? What was his career? Whether he was a teacher or a doctor or an engineer or an activist or a social worker or a scientist, whatever he is. And major accomplishments means in his career or in his whole professional journey, what he has acquired, what achievements he has made. Then competencies and interest. Competencies means the qualities that we hold, his likes and dislikes. And the interest means what was his core area of working, where he had the main interest. Okay, so these main things we are supposed to discuss in our biographical sketch. Clear, children? Now after that, we have to be careful that our biography must be concise. Concise means choti honi chahiye. It must be short, not very lengthy. So how it would be possible? How we can make our biographical sketch concise, brief? As a sketch, it is going to be a condensed version of a fuller biography. So select only the most noteworthy information and sentiments. Means you will talk about the main features, the core. You will provide the core information, the things that are important to know for others. You are not going to discuss the easy silly things like what he used to, when he used to get up, when he used to go to sleep, who were his friends, what he used to play. These all are not that much important as much it is that who were the people who had an impact on his life, or what was his achievement, or the place from where he has completed his schooling. These informations are better to inform rather than talking about the common easy things that took place in his life. Cleared? Now, highlight achievements and influences. As I told you, try to highlight notable achievements. Notable achievement means that can really considered as something unique or special that will impress the audience, okay, and make the subject a more memorable one. Okay, the person, suppose the subject you have chosen to write, you are talking about his academic. So if you say that in class 1 he scored first position, in class 2 also he scored first position, in 3 also he scored first position, so this is not delighting the reader. If you talk about his graduation level achievements or national level achievements or international level achievement, so that is going to mark him as a unique person. Okay, that he has done something extraordinary. So while writing a biography, we must try to include the outstanding achievements of that person. Okay, don't discuss the common achievement, the easy ones. After that, mention how these accomplishments affected the subject's life. Means after these achievements, what impact those things have made on his life. This is also important to mention. Okay, how he got the inspiration that he had tried for better. Then arrange your information. Arrangement, as I told you, the sequencing of the events, the date and the incident should be in such a manner, means it should be chronicle. Means first we discuss about the person's birth, then his academics, then his career, then his experiences, and after that we talk about his achievements. If we discuss about the career first and then we talk about their schooling, so this is a wrong way, children. Okay, so in the first para we discuss about a person's physical appearance, how the person looks like, whether he is a tall or a short or a stout person. Then we talk about his complexion, whether he is a fair, whitish or a dark complexion person. Then is he a tall or a short person, as I told you. Then we talk about his nature also. Is he a kind or gentle person or a clumsy, grumpy person? Okay, so after that we discuss about his academic, as I told you, that from where he completed his schooling, then from where he had done his graduation. And after that, we discuss about the career, that how he became famous in his field and how he has chosen that career. Okay, once all the necessary information is gathered, retell the person's life in chronicle order, or lead with the major achievements and then circle back to tell their full story. Means in the two ways we can write the biographical sketch. The first one, we start right from his birth, name, birthplace, and as I told you, academic, family background and all that. The second way is, first we give a brief introduction of those achievements that has made that subject a prominent person, has given him an international image. And after that, we switch to discuss about his that date of birth and all things. Okay, the basic information. Now, the next point in writing the biographical sketch is, it should be written in third form. Third form means, children, he, she, his or her. Such pronouns are used while writing a biographical sketch. It is never ever written in first person or second person pronoun. Cleared? Now, emphasize on portraying a person in an admirable manner. Means we must try to create a positive image of our subject. Instead of talking about his negative traits, it's better to talk about his good qualities, what good he has or what good he has done his life. Okay? Now it's time to write a biography. Here we are going to write a biographical sketch of Marie Kondo, an Indian amateur boxer, in your own words, in not more than 100 to 120 words, with the help of given clues, children. Now, see, here in the question, the name is given and the word limit is mentioned. Apart of that, the clues are also given, children. Okay, whenever this question is given in the in exam, you always get the clues. As Marie Kondo is a famous personality and we people know many of his information, so it is easy to mention the date of birth or family background or education and all that. Okay, but in case if you are writing the biographical sketch about any of your family members or your gardener or the milkman or the vegetable seller, in that case, as they are not that much special and we don't have their basic information, so we just simply mention that, give the brief description about their physical appearance, then their academic qualification, their career experiences, in such a manner. Okay, so in two ways this question can be asked. So here you can see that the date of birth of Marie Kondo, her family background, education, sport category in which she is known as, then achievements and awards have been given in the clues. Now we are going to do the bio sketch. So class, in bio sketch, at first we mention the person's name on which you are going to write the biography. Okay, so don't forget, whomsoever you have chosen as a subject, that person's name will come at the top. My subject is Marie Kondo, so I have mentioned Marie Kondo. So when I ask you to do a bio sketch on a person, so whosoever you will choose, that person's name will be mentioned at the top. Only after that you will start discussing about or start giving the detail about his life journey. Here, Magit Chung Gilchang, famous as Marie Kondo, is an Indian amateur boxer, politician and incumbent member of parliament, Rajya Sabha, from the northeast states of Manipur. She was born on 1st March 1983 in Manipur. Kondo completed her schooling from Loktal Christian Model High School and St. Xavier Catholic School up to 8th standard at Moriang. During this time, she got a deep interest in athletics. After that, she completed her studies from NIOS. She is also known as MC Marie Kondo or Magnificent Marie. Clear? Here I have given the detail of her basic information, the family background and her academic and her date of birth, full name, everything that is given. Now my second paragraph is about her career. Marie Kondo has illustrious career in boxing. She won 7 medals at World Championship by 2019. In 2010, she bagged a bronze in 51 kg category and a gold in 2014 Asian Games in the same category by improving her own medal tally. In the 2012 Olympics, she became the first Indian woman boxer to qualify and win a bronze medal in the 51 kg flyweight category of boxing. In Commonwealth Games 2018, she won the 48 kg boxing category. Because of her historical career, Marie Kondo was awarded the Arjun Award in 2003, Padma Shri in 2006, And in 2009, the boxer was lauded with Rajiv Gandhi Khel Ratna Award, the highest sporting honor in the country. Now, at the last, I am concluding this biography. The 36-year-old has an 18-year-long illustrious career with 6 world championships, an Olympic bronze medal, and 5 Asian championships to show. The star had announced her retirement after winning gold medal at Tokyo Olympics in 2020. Mary Kom has been honored with Padma Bhushan in 2013 and Padma Vibhushan in 2020. So here my biography is over. You can see that I have included the code, the important information only. Nothing extra has been included. Even she has made many more achievements. She has won many more awards, many more medals. But the main, the thing that really make her special, only that description has been given. Clear, children? Now, I have one more biography for you. This is about your favorite teacher. Write a biographical sketch on your favorite teacher, not more than 100 or 120 words, with the help of given clues. So here you can see the difference between the clues. That is why I have taken this example, children. The clues that were given in Mary Kom's biography, there the particular date, achievement, academy, the name of the school, the medals, everything was mentioned. But here it is on your favorite teacher, so that could be anybody. And as it is, it could be anybody, not a specific person. So the clues are given in such a form, like his age is 25 years. Here we are talking about a particular person as my favorite teacher. So I have given, mentioned the age also, like he is of 25 years. That physical appearance, he is a fair, complexed, and looks like a film hero. Then he teaches computer with example and silence, how the class was an enjoyable experience. Then he loves his love for children. Then his, I will give a description about his nature. He is kind, patient, and ever smiling person. Now, the name of my teacher is Mr. Kumar. Like others, I too have my favorite teacher, and that is Mr. Kumar. He is 25 years old and has a good physical appearance. He is fair, complex, and looks like a film hero. He teaches his computers. His method of teaching is very interesting and thought-provoking. He teaches through examples which make us understand the topic clearly. His method is so good that all of us wait for his period. There is a pin drop silence in the class and all listen to him with full attention. So the whole class enjoys his teaching. Mr. Kumar has a great love for children. As a man, he is kind, patient, and ever smiling. He is loved by all due to his qualities. May he live long. Okay, children? Now, so once again, revise that what points you have to keep remember while writing a biography. You have to mention the full name of your subject, his date of birth and place of birth. Then you have to include the major personality traits of your subject. After that, you will give a brief description about his educational qualification. Then you will highlight any major achievements or the awards. After that, you will write about his contribution to the society. And if he has any special interest in any of the things, so that will be given. That will be mentioned in your biography. After that, why he or she is famous for or known for. And that means the things, the achievement that he made because of which he got a prominent that image in the society or the country. So, children, I want you all to please write choose some of the topics from your site and write their biography, graphical sketch on your own. That's all for today's class, children. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.